Welcome to Stars TV, everyone. After the Cardiff game where Stars picked up the result of the season with a 3-2 shootout victory, we're going to be speaking to coach Dan Ceman and man of the match, Brennan Turner.
Hi, Dan. So we're back to winning ways. It's got to be good, especially with a short bench. I mean, against such a strong team as Cardiff, there's probably a lot of the fans were sort of thinking, oh, doom and gloom, yeah. But certainly good to get back on the winning column.
Yeah, well, it's been a rough week. 10 days, to be exact, of 6 games in 10 days, travelling all over the place. Yeah. Losing some guys to injury, and it was just a remarkable performance tonight. I think yesterday was an outstanding performance as well, but we just lacked a little belief in ourselves and we panicked in the third period. We talked today about just whatever happens, believe in yourselves and don't panic. There's no reason to panic. We have a good enough team in here to hold on to wins, to hold on to leads late in the game. So just believe in yourselves and keep playing. And we did that. Even though we gave up a goal beginning of the third period, I thought we didn't falter. We didn't panic at all. We played them even after that and got some good chances after that as well.
Just to touch on that with the third period goal, we let in a goal yesterday, about 40 seconds into the third period again to tie the game up. Were you sort of just getting on at the team to not let their heads down, make sure we played the rest of the period?
I mean, a big part of the pre-game speech was, whatever happens in the third period, if we're tied, we're even, we're one behind, we just keep playing the same way. You don't get on your heels, you don't back up, you stay aggressive, you keep playing. You don't doubt yourself. And I thought we doubted ourselves yesterday, and after that one goal went in, we just pretty much fell apart. Defensively, we started to back off and give them way too much room. And today we didn't. We stayed aggressive and we stayed on them as much as we were able to with all the fatigue and injuries and that. And the heart that we displayed all through the night, but especially in the third period and overtime, was outstanding.
Yeah. On a personal note, you were injured through the week down in Nottingham, and I believe it's a concussion, so never a good one to get. How are you feeling? What's the sort of prognosis for return for you?
I'm feeling fine. It was mild. Symptoms cleared up in a couple of days, but you pretty much have to protocol these days says you have to take a week off.
Yeah.
So I'll be back on the ice. I'll probably ride the bike Monday, Tuesday, and be back on the ice Wednesday, and I have no question that I'll be ready to go.
Yeah. How good has it been for the team to have you behind the bench, like, from your sort of point of view?
To be honest, I haven't really had a chance to kind of reflect on that, but it certainly is much easier to focus on exactly what's going on from the coaching's perspective. I see the ice from a different way,
yeah.
And it's been fun, and I think it can lead to some effective things being done. But obviously, I'm really
itching to get back.
To get back on the ice, and I can't wait to get back on the ice. But I think I can take some things that I learned in the last 2 days moving forward to how I view the game while I'm playing as well. So it could be an advantage.
6.8 seconds left in the overtime, and we gave them a face-off in our zone. What on earth did you say to the players there? Because we're standing watching the game, and we're trying to think, what would you say to them? But from a coach's point of view.
Well, before that, what I said to the ref can't be repeated because Husey dove for it and touched the puck at center ice, so it shouldn't have been an icing, but all three of the officials missed it. But we just said that we just designated who had who, and that was the key part.
Yeah.
So as long as we take away their time and space and everybody knows who's got each individual player on their team, then I went through a couple different things that they might show on their face-off play, and everybody knew there was no miscommunication or confusion, and everybody took their guy, so it was not an issue.
Just to finish off, double Scotland header this week, down in Fife and then back up here for Brayhead. How are you feeling about those games?
Well, they're huge. They're huge. Obviously, this is a big boost for our positivity and our way forward, and there's lots of things we did in this past week that we can build on. There's certainly some circumstances involved in only getting the 2 points tonight, but I think tonight was an unbelievable display of heart and commitment and passion, and we take that moving forward. And the big thing, we have mentioned in the past how the couple of games that we've won this year, we didn't have the best week at practice. We were maybe a little too high on ourselves. And as excited and happy as we are with tonight's performance, we have to be just as focused, even more so when we're back on the ice. And because November is a huge month, and next weekend is the start of it, and we'll be focused and ready to go.
Well, looking forward to it, Dan. We'll see you again next week.
Thanks.
Welcome to Stars TV with Brennan Turner. I'm just going to ask you the obvious first of all. How does it feel to get your first two goals?
Great, obviously. I mean, we've been... I mean, goals and points are kind of an added bonus to wins, and last six games, or even the month of October, it's been a bit of a struggle, and we've been working hard and just can't seem to put the final pieces together to get the 2 points like we wanted to in most games. And you know, I just try to leave it all on the ice, try it every night, and manage to chip in two tonight. Some nights it's another guy that does it. So you know, I just try to do my part, and I'm glad that we got the 2 points tonight versus another loss. So
yeah. Does it feel any better to get them against Cardiff after you had, shall we say, a disagreement with Mr. Voth down there last time?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, the first goal there, he was covering me back door, and I don't know, he just kind of went to La La Land there and didn't realize what he was doing, and picked up the puck and just potted in the back of the net for the first one, which was nice. And, you know, him and I have exchanged words. I think as a tough guy, legitimate tough guy, which he is, there's one thing that you should know is that you don't hit a guy when he's down. That's what he did against me down in Cardiff, and that's why I think he's more of, you know, it wasn't very classy move by him, and that's why I voiced my frustration. And you know, from what I've heard, he's kind of like that, but it's neither here nor there. It doesn't affect how I play. I know I heard some things about them saying I was going to be looking over my shoulder the entire game tonight, but kind of seemed to be the other way around because I happened to have more ice and was able to move the puck a little bit easier. And I think they were just looking for me to do something, you know, go after somebody and do something stupid. But in hindsight, it ended up benefiting myself and also the team.
Yeah. The Cardiff were a bit sort of chippy. They were a bit aggressive. There was a lot of, I felt, in my opinion, cheap shots tonight from Cardiff. Was that a conscious effort from the team to try and ignore that and just get on with the game and try and force them into silly penalties?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, when we were down there last weekend, we ran ourselves into some penalty trouble, and that's basically what bit us in the butt. I mean, we were in the penalty box way too much down in Cardiff, and that's because we were trying to play their type of game, you know, retaliation penalties, that sort of thing. And, you know, even some of the calls were questionable, but regardless, we got to keep our cool more often than not. And tonight we did, and it paid dividends. I mean, we got the one PP goal there, PP power play goal, sorry, and you know, put them in the box, put some of their better players in the box for 10-minute misconduct because they just couldn't keep their mouth shut. And at the end of the day, that's what we want. You know, we don't want to put ourselves in a situation where we go down, you know, to some of our best players in the box. You know, there's situations where I could have dropped the gloves, or I could have, you know, gave a cross check to somebody here and there, but you know, when myself or Mazur, some of the forwards like Husey and AJ, they're playing so many minutes, we can't afford for them to have, you know, be in the box all the time. So I think, you know, you gotta level it out and pick your spots and choose your spots when to engage yourself in those sort of situations.
And just on a final note, we've obviously got had quite a few injuries lately. Has that, I mean, since we've had these injuries, we went down to Sheffield last night, and although we lost, that was a 5-goal game, which is a big improvement, and tonight, a great effort. Has that, the injuries helped sort of bond the team more, help them play harder for each other with guys missing?
Yeah, I think, I mean, anytime, you know, you face adversity, you try to rely on each other, lean on each other more, and you know, make each other more accountable. So that's what we've been preaching in the dressing room, trying to make sure that everyone's doing their job right, especially in the D zone. I mean, there was a couple of goals over the last week, the last six games here that, you know, we wish we could have taken back just because we were kind of lost in the D zone. So we've been really preaching that in the dressing room. And, I mean, the guys that are hurt and they're playing through it are, you know, gutsy performers.
Yeah.
I'm not going to name names, obviously, but, you know, they're guys that are character players on the team, and everyone sees that, and it kind of makes them go a little bit harder themselves. So, you know, we credit them for everything they're putting forth, and without them, you know, we wouldn't have got the win tonight, that's for sure.
All right, Brian, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
Congrats on the goals.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Thank you.